I hope you agree with me that the onion skin in Moho is not perfect. It's pretty hard to navigate, doesn't show the masks, and it's pretty slow too. There is an alternative way to analyze this patient. The show path option in the transform bone tool. However, that only works with bones that aren't bone to anything. And if there is any animation of the layer transformation, the show path doesn't make much sense because the path moves along with the layer itself and doesn't show the real position of the bones on the screen. To deal with the problem of making the analysis of animation more precise and convenient, I created the MR path script. It joined the family of such scripts as MR overlay and MR guides. They understand each other and can work together. Make sure, however, that the version of the MR overlay that you have is 1.2 or later for the scripts to work together correctly. MR path allows you to form a list of bones and points you'd like to track and draw their trajectories on the screen. It helps to verify spacing and trajectories of different parts of the character. The draw trajectory is global, so it works with layer transformation and even camera movement. It can be used on any points or bones. However, the path is not getting updated in real time, so every time you make changes, you need to redraw the path to see the update. Let's see how to use the script. The first three buttons allow you to add the selected bones and points to the list, remove them from the list, or completely clear the list. No need to select the bones and points every time. You just need to add them to the list once, and you can redraw their paths regardless of the selected layer or action. You can view the list by clicking the Path Target Manager button. Here you can see the information of the objects, change the colors, randomize them, select what should be tracked for the bone, either the tip or the base, and you can also remove objects from the list. The next three buttons are needed to control the path. You can create the path, it will create a new layer where the path will be drawn. You can delete the path from the layer or delete the layer itself. The next option are responsible for the look of the paths, the opacity of the entire layer, the width of the path, and its color. You can also enable the tick marks and their size, so you can see where exactly the changes happened in your animation. The draw center line option will be useful in the situations when you need to track multiple paths that are crossing each other, so you could better understand their location and direction. The track bone tip option defines if the tip or the base of the bone should be tracked. The next option defines in what frames the path will be drawn. The number of frames before and after the current one, selected timeline range, or manually entry of the from and to frame numbers. The script comes with an additional helping script that triggers the process of path creation. You can assign a hotkey for it and use it to conveniently refresh the path after you make changes in your animation. I use this script a lot. It helps not only to just check my own animation, but to also visually demonstrate other animators what mistakes they made and how to fix them. If you find my script interesting for you, I will be happy if you share your feedback. Thank you.